Good evening, this is the Oscar Expert here with Brother Bro. We are going to review Bombshell. This film stars Nicole Kidman, Margot Robbie, and Charlize Theron. They work at Fox News. Nicole Kidman and Charlize Theron are playing real-life anchors there. It's about the takedown of harasser and sexual predator Roger Ailes. It's about how Gretchen Carlson unleashed the takedown of cover-up culture. I think what it does really well is it explores how this culture like permeated every individual woman's decision as to whether or not to speak out against this, and how difficult it is for these women psychologically. Like, there's so much at stake for them just telling the truth. You understand like why they really didn't feel like they had a choice. I mean, we live in a world where you can lose your job for speaking out about something like that, and you know, losing your job is like everything. Your hopes and your dreams, but it's also your income, your like public image. I mean, there's just so much at stake. This movie just does a good job about showing how it wasn't just one person who did this. Like, it couldn't have been just one person. Everybody had to decide together, like team up and be like very like legitimately brave to take down this kind of culture. This movie kind of takes the approach where it goes for a lot of different angles, a lot of different characters' perspectives, and it gives you like a broad scope of this issue. Charles Randolph wrote it and he did The Big Short, so it's sort of similar in that style where it's like some of the film focuses on Christian Bale, some on Steve Carell, some on Brad Pitt, you know, wherever it needs to go to like tell you the story of
different stakeholders,
how it all happened. The three main characters, they all had like different roles in this takedown, and the film wisely like kind of distinguishes each one and like the different kind of players that you can have in this sort of thing.
I was not let down by the fact that the writer of The Big Short did this movie. I felt like both these movies do a really good job in showing how the structures exist and how they're really hard to topple.
I think it's a necessity for a story like this to be told through that lens where, you know, I think it was like a really powerful movie and one that could actually inspire people to make these necessary changes. It didn't feel like this movie bludgeoned me over the head with like, oh, this is like your hero for this story. They're fighting for like good and that's it. Like,
yeah.
It wasn't so rah-rah like, oh, this is the obvious solution. Like, we just have to do this. It shows why it was difficult, why it still is difficult for people, and like what barriers are in their way to achieving this. And like, there's conflicts with the women in this movie as to whether they should come forward, and that's just honest. Like, that's part of how this culture works, is the way that it works to suppress people, you know, from opening their own mouths. Charlize Theron is playing Megyn Kelly in this movie, and, you know, the way they show Megyn Kelly, she's not like, you know, oh, I'm going to stand up to this. Like, she doesn't really want that kind of attention. You know, she's doing it because she feels like internally that this is like something that she should do for herself. Everybody in this movie is constantly like, oh, I'm not a feminist. Like, they like don't want to be called a feminist. And it's like funny. But and Margot Robbie's character, too, you know, she doesn't want like to be the hero or anything. You know, the way that the characters start out kind of ambivalent to this culture, and they slowly kind of like it eats away at them and they realize that this problem is bigger than them. I think that was compelling. All three characters kind of underwent that arc. You know, it's not just that there's this one guy who is a harasser at the top. There's constant sexist remarks, a general like toxic culture to Fox News. And it's not, it didn't feel like it was telling me like Fox News is toxic. It's this Republican culture that's toxic. You know, maybe that's like obviously part of it, but it felt like this kind of culture is definitely existing in a lot of industries, including Hollywood.
Any like, newsroom, too. Yeah. It didn't feel like this was just a jab at like Fox News and everything else is great. CNN, MSNBC, they're all great. The fact that the head of Fox News or any company can have so much influence about what people say and what people believe and what they like in their private lives is a critique of the entire media establishment, not just Fox News. The dogma and the monolithic thought that you have to have in this work environment. You know, we're the news, but you have to think this way. You have to think like us. And also, this is a good example of the culture working, like, everybody is kind of playing a part in it. They did an interesting thing with, like, how the women on the show are asked to wear skirts, but the women on the show will defend the fact that they wear short dresses and say, like, well, no, I mean, I'm choosing to wear this. But really, like, the establishment never gave them a choice. It's even these things that people are not even picking up on who are unknowingly, like, participating in this culture. And it's not their fault. Like, these are the victims, even though they're, like, perpetuating it. And I think that's, like, a good thing to understand with the movie. I also like that it didn't go too hard at, like, being anti-Republican, anti-Fox News, because it's just so obvious and, like, easy to just go for those jabs. And they do them. They do those jabs. But it's not to the point where anybody is, like, dehumanized. I mean, I think we can obviously agree that there are heroes in this movie despite their political beliefs. I think it's ridiculous how people are backlashing this movie for being sympathetic towards, like, human beings that work at Fox who have Republican beliefs. It's ridiculous, but...
Now, let's talk about the performances, because this movie, as we know, like, overperformed at the SAG Awards. Maybe not even overperformed. I mean, it kind of deserved the nominations. Yeah. We got Charlize Theron, Margot Robbie, and Nicole Kidman, the trio of this movie.
I feel like they have almost equal screen time.
Yeah, I would say so. I would say it's sort of like a favorite situation.
Yeah, it's like the favorite.
My impression was that Charlize Theron is, like, you know, she's the big contender for lead. Margot Robbie's big and supporting. And then Nicole Kidman's, like, sort of on a lower level. To me, Nicole Kidman was easily, like, at least on the level of Margot Robbie and Charlize
Theron. She was maybe my favorite performance
in the movie,
actually.
Her performance felt really real, and, like, the way that she's kind of, like, quietly, fiercely going after what she really believes, it felt very honest. You know, Charlize Theron is fantastic as Megyn Kelly.
She just nails, like, the whole voice and the way that she is.
Yeah,
and that, like, determination, the loyalty, like...
The whole transformation aspect is, you know, kind of helping her. And then Margot Robbie is more, like, the emotional core of the movie. It's fun to watch it bounce back between these three because they kind of have different angles and different personalities. Each performance is enjoyable in its own right. There's John Lithgow as Roger Ailes, who did a really great job.
He was very good.
As somebody who's, like, such an asshole, he could have been a cartoonish villain easily. But I don't know how he subverted that. Like, he just didn't feel like...
He made you understand how people will say, oh, I like working with that guy. Like, he made you get that. He was, like, an angry, belligerent man that, like, people had to coddle to, which is how, like, these people are. Some of these people who are, like, very demanding and in control, like, they have to be treated like babies a little bit. And, like, that's kind of what was happening here.
And you also see, like, the excuses that he makes for himself. He's not somebody who goes around thinking, like, I'm evil and I do evil things and I'm a bad guy. Like, he doesn't
he's doing something bad. It, like, really nailed that. This is not a monster that you just can't imagine. Oh, my God. You know, Roger Ailes, what a sick person. Like, this guy could exist, you know, in your same building. Like, you don't know where these people are.
Yeah, he was maybe on par with the other three.
Yeah,
I mean, I see, like, why he's not getting awards hype. It just feels more, like, right to award the heroes of the movie in a way. You know, there's a bunch of fun cameos, you know, thrown around here and there. Allison Janney and Kate McKinnon were the ones that surprised me the most, and that they were actually, like, really good.
Allison Janney was barely in it. Okay.
She was in it enough that I was like, oh.
Kate McKinnon was very good in this movie, actually. That surprised me, because she didn't hide behind, like, some character or some impression that she's doing being funny. Like, she was just, like, very real in one scene. I was like, wow.
And then there are lots of cameos. You know, someone's playing Rudy Giuliani and Bill O'Reilly and other people. You know, all the friendly faces that you see at Fox.
I really do think Margot Robbie is great in this, too. You know, she gets that naivete across in the movie, but without losing respect for who this person is. I feel like Margot Robbie seem to have, like, a lot of respect for this character, despite her being someone who, like, you can think she's, like, a little bit funny, or, like, you could laugh at her a little bit for being, like, the way she is. I felt like she really dug her heels into, like, the heart of this character and empathized with her. I was really impressed with all three performances in the movie. I think they're, like, equally as good. I'd actually be upset if Nicole Kidman didn't get a nomination. I want to say she's a lock, even though she didn't get nominated other places. Like, I want to say she's, like, I feel like she's easily going to get in.
This movie has somewhat mixed reviews. I think the main criticism is that it's, like, it played it too safe, or it didn't, like, go far enough or deep enough. To an extent, I don't agree, because I think the movie did a really good job of, like, showing the inner workings of this system. But I kind of agree in that I think it could have been, like, a more emotionally compelling movie. It really gave me a very well-rounded perspective of everything, but it wasn't as heavy on, like, focusing in on, like, a character or, like, you know, this being, like, a particular person's emotional journey. I think for a story like this, it might have made sense to lean into that more.
I don't really have any problems with the movie. I think it's, like, very well done, but it's not going to be, like, every critic's, like, cup of tea, just because it's definitely going for being an audience-pleasing movie, like, a drama that's just, like, more easy to watch and digest. That's just what it is. And I actually want a lot of people to be seeing this movie. I'd rather this be a movie where a lot of people want to go in and see it, are entertained. Why does this have like a 63 on Rotten Tomatoes? I really don't get it. I think this might be like maybe the most important movie of the year. The fact that it does a good job at like exploring that topic more so than any other movie, like, it might be the most important movie.
Most audiences are gonna like the movie. I find
it, I hope so,
easy to recommend. And I think it's like a movie that will do positive impact.
I'd even be happy if the movie got nominated for Best Picture. Like, I wouldn't care. I'd be like, cool, that makes sense.
I think the reviews wouldn't be telling of that. I think that if this movie like really hits with audiences, like, it could sneak in there maybe.
I want to see if it gets the PGA. That's what I'm really looking out for. And I think it will. I really do.
I'm going to go with 8 out of 10 on this one.
I will say 9 out of 10. It exceeded my expectations.
Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing.
Go you. You're a rock star.